This is an 11-month-old baby who weighs 10 kilograms. He was diagnosed as having a ventricular septal defect with what we call DCRVs, a double-chambered right ventricle with muscle blocking the outflow of blood from his right ventricle. So he's going to have repair of his VSD and his DCRV. All right, so we'll approach this through a median sternotomy incision. We'll try and do the repair through the right atrium, minimize trauma to the right ventricle. The challenge here is you have to take most of the thymus out just to create space without damaging the phrenic nerves, which pass right along the surface of it down into the down to the diaphragm. Twisting pericardium, we use this for the patch repair of the ventricular septal defect so that it's all the child's own tissue. And we'll take enough that if we need to put a patch on the right ventricular outflow tract, we can do that with native pericardium as well. Here you can see the pericardium. There's a heart, beautiful aorta and the pulmonary artery about the same size. And sick babies just touching that atrium can precipitate an SVT. This baby's in good shape, so there's no problem. There's 4 cc's of heparin. We'll just inject this through our purse string into the right atrium, pull back, make sure there's no air bubbles. Inject. Okay, heparin's in. Needle back. This is the aortic cannula, so we're going to insert that about a centimeter in. 11 blade. Watch your eyes. Puncture. Knife down. Cannula. Good. Crank secures it. Tourniquet, pull it back. So go on. So this baby's now going on bypass. And you'll see the heart will decompress, we'll be able to turn the lungs off, and we'll be able to see everything better inside the operative field. So make a small hole, spread very gently with that curved snap. And the cannula should slide right in, and there should be no resistance as it goes down the inferior vena cava. When we remove that clamp, and you can see the venous blood is now being drained effectively from the lower body. Left atrium, we're going to put a purse string, triangular shaped purse string here, so that we can place a vent into the left atrium and decompress the left ventricle while we're repairing this VSD. That'll keep blood out of the operative field as well. And the superior vena cava, knife down, superior vena cava cannula up into the SVC so we can achieve caval isolation. And we check the headsets and make sure that they're safe. They're in the 75 range and rising. And these are the PAs. We'll control the left and right PAs so that there's no back bleeding into our operative field. Reduce your flow.
Flow is down.
Clamps on.
Leech is on.
Knife. So I just cut the wall of the left atrium. Vent on. Okay, so we're placing stay sutures just beneath the pulmonary annulus in the right ventricle and the infundibulum. We're checking to make sure there's a true LAD, which there is, it's right there. There's no dual LAD that we can see going down to the apex. There's a small coronary branch that goes down to the apex, but it's not a major branch. That jet of flow through that VSD is creating all the scar tissue. Originating at the VSD, these are papillary muscles in the right ventricular outflow tract. These are some more muscle bundles that we just wouldn't have been able to safely cut from the right atrium. You can see how I can look at them clearly. And we're not going to cut outside the heart, and I can cut each one of these muscle fibers safely and precisely. The DCRV repair is done except for the patch that we'll put on top of this. There's some muscle bundle right here that we can take out.
picture taken.
Here's the VSD in the center of the picture. My forceps is inside the defect here. And here you can see the aortic valve prolapsing through the defect.
Stay away from the aortic valve leaflet. We're not going to touch the conduction system. So you can see the edge of the patch now conforms to the edge of the VSD. And we can run the suture line right across and connect to the previous suture. End of school.
Here's the patch on the ventricular septal defect.
That's about right. Okay. 7.
You can flatten the bed out here.
We inspected the pulmonary valve with the endoscope and it looked fine.
Okay, so we'll just even out these two suture lines and run around each side. And then all we need to do is close up the atrium and baby's fixed. We're coming around the inferior margin of our patch. Trying to take epicardial bites. Muscle doesn't hold suture very well. So here you can see the patch, evenly distributed sutures. We tried to minimize the size of the incision in the infundibula. We've got all the muscle bundles, you say. We've got a good look at the pulmonary valve, we have good exposure to the VSD. Now we just have to close the atrium and we're all set. Endoscope. Picture.
We routinely take these operative images and store them in each patient's electronic medical record.
Okay, reduce your flow.
Close down.
This is the aortic cross clamp coming off. Baby's head is down, so no air can go to the head. We'll allow the bleeding to continue to come out the aortic root so that all air bubbles come out that way. There's the first few beats of the atrium. The ventricle is not coordinated with the atrium yet, but that'll happen in a minute. Okay, so you can see the atrium and the ventricle are contracting and sinking out. We have sinus rhythm. We're going to take out this vent. So this is in the left atrium. Okay, we're off bypass. I'm going to clamp the sewing the cannulation site. We'll put the chest tube in next, and then
we don't say goodbye.